water feature lovers, welcome back to episode 20 of the Oasis at Modern Design. I appreciate you guys joining our team as we continue to transform my mundane, boring vinyl siding house into one of the most amazing aquatic paradises on planet Earth. We're gonna be doing some landscaping, some gas work, some boulder work. You guys know the routine if you've been following along. Do me a favor, guys, like, comment, subscribe, all that. Enjoy the journey. Thanks for hanging in with the Adams family and taking a spin at the Oasis at Modern Design.
One of the biggest things I think that I want to talk about with you guys is the landscaping around a water feature and how important it is. Guys, I want to just pound this into your brain right now. I'm planting our garden here at the Oasis, how I would recommend you plant your water feature. It's up to you what you're gonna do, obviously, but layers upon layers of plants and colors and big wide swaths of things, not one of everything. Lots of creeping ground covers. I actually had the team digging dirt out from between the boulders, and we're putting a nice potting mix in so that we have beautiful soil in our planting areas. If you're not putting a lot of soil amendments in with your plant material around your water feature here in Tennessee, you're not gonna get great results. You'll get good results, but not great results. I think it's very important that you spend some money on some quality soil, at least soil amending. I put like almost 300 Mondo grasses under this Japanese maple because in my head I have this effect of the beautiful structure of the tree, a nice lush dark green under that vibrant chartreusey green of the leaves, and then some painted ferns to pop out to just bring out some different heights. But if you think about what you normally see at the river, what do you see? You see a majority of one plant, and then you'll have another plant or two that's sporadically throughout. I'm trying to create a natural feeling here, but the guys are working. We're putting in irrigation. We're finally hooking the gas lines back up, and we're gonna have a fire boulder up top in the swim pond area when we get to there. There's gonna be a few fire features around here. We're working on some fire pits to actually get fire pits made with our logo in them right now. Those guys are working on that. Sean, my buddy, is coming over today and he's bringing Sawyer's basket. If you guys don't know about the Sawyer Mason Foundation, that's our foundation. I'm gonna put like 75 links up here. Make sure you check that out. Do something good for the world. But we had him custom fabricate the most amazing flower basket. There's three pillars I'm gonna look at outside my window up there over top of the swim pond. I said, we need Sawyer's basket. This is a flower basket that's a memorial to my grandson. It needs to be magnitude awesome to make me smile every time I look out my window and think of Sawyer. That thing's showing up today. I can't tell you how big that is in my heart. I'm excited about that. I'm excited about the gas and the irrigation that's coming in. All of this is gonna be self-sustaining, a proper garden, if you will. You guys stay tuned, thanks.
Let me introduce you to my little friend.
This will be my 4-foot ring. This will probably be the most challenging because I've got 15 feet of material I've got to roll. I've tried to run it narrower to reduce waste, but when you're doing large pieces like this, you want these rollers to be a wide stance. Couple of reasons, puts less stress on the machine. And also I believe it gives it more leverage. So your piece, as it starts to get an arc in it, you got a lot of weight up in the air. It keeps it from wanting to fall over. I'm making sure I've got the weld at 12 o'clock and I'm making sure that my weld stays at 12 o'clock. That way I know that it's not trying to lay over on me. See in there, it's trying to lay over. So what I'll do is I'll relieve the pressure. Theoretically, you can get a spot in your arc doing that, but because we're not even close to being done yet, it'll work itself out. Yeah, see, it's starting to get an arc, so it's wanting to lay over on me here. Now I think now that we got a pretty good arc going here, the dies are just off center enough that it's got leverage on the loop now. And it'll help keep it straight. Even from my best efforts, we're still about a foot from each other here, so we're just gonna have to keep with it. Even for my best efforts, that's still what we ended up with. It's right on 4 feet. So now, what I have to do now is just kind of work this and try to convince it to straighten up for me.
How you doing, buddy?
Good.
You glad to be getting this thing out of your barn? Good to see you this morning, man.
Good to see you.
Well, do I get this thing out of here?
Sure.
Thank you, man. Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm talking about right there.
How awesome is that?
Thank you, sir.
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing.
So that center column right there, looking out through the window.
I got flagstone caps that go on there, and I'm just gonna set it right on top of the cap on the center column. I'm gonna run water up through the middle of it so it'll have its own drip irrigation built right into it. I intend to put chicken wire maybe layer inside, and then I'm gonna do a coconut, put one of those in there and just fill it full of soil. I'm gonna stick plants out through the sides over the top. I'll make it crazy. I'll have a lot of fun with it. It'll be the thing you're staring straight out of the front window at it, so.
Tell me some of the details about making this thing. I mean, do you remember roughly how many hours you spent on this project?
I believe it was over 20 for sure, but the challenge was getting the circles rolled and getting them rolled where they were straight. The first project I've done with rings like this. That inner ring was probably the most challenging because I had to make two halves and then weld it together because the ring itself is too small to go through the machines.
I got you.
You know, I've drawn up a little bit on paper, but most of it was just thinking how I wanted it to look and figuring out how to hold some of the initial components.
It's awesome. Absolutely awesome. Thanks, man.
Yep, no problem.
Well, there you have it, guys. Another episode in the books. The progress continues. The process continues. There's a lot of cool things going on here at Modern Design. Follow our other stuff as well. The boys on Facebook, all that. Like, comment, subscribe. Smash the bell. You know what you need to do. We're going to keep on building amazing water features and doing things that matter with people that matter. Thanks for hanging with the Adams family.